Welcome to Gemara Academy. In this class, we will learn the Gemara Masechta Shabbos on Daf Ches Amar Aleph. Let's begin. On Daf Vav Amar Aleph, we presented a brisa that spoke about the four rishuyos of Shabbos: a rishus hayachid, a rishus harabim, a karmelis, and a makom ptur. From after that brisa till this piece of Gemara, we discussed the first part of the brisa that spoke about a rishus hayachid, a rishus harabim, and a karmelis, the rishuyos where there is an isser involved in caring by them. In this piece of Gemara and the next piece of Gemara, we're going to bring some additional teachings that relate to these three rishuyos. So in our piece, there's going to be two teachings about caring from rishus hayachid to rishus harabim. Let's see the Gemara inside. Amar Abaya, Abaya said, Zara kaveris l'rishus harabim, if one threw a basket to the rishus harabim, and these baskets were made out of reeds, and they were round, it was a circular basket. The din is gevaya yud ve'ena rechavavav, if it's 10 tfachim high, but it's not 6 tfachim wide, or across the middle of the basket, the circle, the diameter, is not 6 tfachim wide, chayev, the person's chayev, and like Rashi will explain, that although generally a rishus hayachid is 10 tfachim high and 4 tfachim by 4 tfachim wide, when it comes to a round object, it has to be 6 tfachim wide in order to be a rishus hayachid. Rashi will explain why that is. So if it's 10 tfachim high, but it's not 6 tfachim wide, then it's just a regular object. It's not a rishus. And the din is chayev, the person's chayev, because he threw an object from the rishus hayachid to the rishus harabim. Rechavavav, if it is 6 tfachim wide, Pater, he's going to be Pater, because now he didn't throw an object from the Rishus HaYachid to the Rishus HaRabim. Rather, he threw a Rishus, because it's a Rishus HaYachid here, from the Rishus HaYachid to the Rishus HaRabim, and we don't find in the Mishkan that they would throw Rishus, and therefore he's going to be Pater. So this is the opinion of Abaya. Rava Amar, Rava said, Rava argues. He says, Afilu Eina Rechavavav, even if it's not 6 Tfachim wide, and therefore it's just a regular object, Pater, the person's Pater. So even though he threw the basket from the Rishus HaYachid to the Rishus HaRabim, and it's an object, not a Rishus, he's still going to be Pater. And what's the reason? So the Gemara explains, Rava says the reason, my time, what's the reason? Because E Efsher Lekrumiyes Shalkana, it's not possible that some slivers of the reed, because the baskets were made out of reeds, it's not possible that some of the slivers of the reeds, Shalayalu Lamaila Masar, that they won't go up high above 10 Tfachim. Since the basket is exactly 10 Tfachim high, it's inevitable that some of the slivers of the reed will extend above 10 Tfachim. So although the person threw an object from the Rishus HaYachid to the Rishus HaRabim, nevertheless he's Pater, since the whole thing did not come to rest in the Rishus HaRabim, rather there are small parts that came to rest in a Mokim Ptur. So we had the teaching of Abaya, that sometimes a person will be Chayiv if it's an object, sometimes he'll be Pater if it's a Rishus, and to that Rava said, he'll actually always be Pater, even when it's an object, because there is a separate thing over here, which is that it's coming to rest in a Mokim Ptur. So in both cases, he'll be Pater. The Gemara now continues to a second teaching about throwing from Rishus HaYachid to the Rishus HaRabim. Kfa Al Pia, if he turned it on its top, and Rashi explains, we're referring to a basket that's not 6 Tfachim wide, so therefore it's certainly categorized as an object, not a Rishus, because it doesn't have 6 Tfachim width. So if he turned it on its top and threw it from the Rishus HaYachid to the Rishus HaRabim, the din is Shivo Mashu Chayiv. If it's 7 and a little bit, he is Chayiv. And for clarity's sake, we're going to say 7.1. So it's 7.1 Tfachim high, he's going to be Chayiv. And the reason is, because although it's on its it's upside down, and therefore the walls are pointing downwards, and therefore we say lavud. And lavud means that once it comes within 3 tfachim of the ground, we view it as if the walls extend to the ground and it's at rest. And again, for clarity's sake, less than 3 tfachim we're going to call 2.9 tfachim. So when it comes by 2.9 tfachim from the ground, it's considered at rest. And the reason the person is going to be chayiv is because even though it's at rest, it's 2.9 plus 7.1 comes out to be 10 tfachim. So it comes out that the whole thing is at rest in the Rishus HaRabim. And this is a teaching from both Abaya and Rava. That's how Rashi explains it. So if it's 7.1 tfachim, the person will be chayiv. If it's shiva umechtza pater, if it's 7.5, he's pater. And like Rashi explains, it doesn't mean 7.5. It means a little more than 7 and a bit. So meaning more than 7.1, we'll call it 7.2. So if it's 7.2 tfachim high, the person will be pater. And the reason is, because when it's 2.9 tfachim from the ground, we say lavud, and the walls extend to the ground, and it's considered at rest. And 2.9 plus 7.2 is 10.1, so it comes out that part of the basket is at rest in a makom ptur, and therefore the person's pater. And now the Gemara presents the opinion of Rav Ashi. Rav Ashi Amar, Rav Ashi said, Afilu shiva omechtza chayiv, even 7.5, or like we said, 7.2, chayiv, the person will be chayiv. And Rav Ashi explains the reason. My time, well, what's the reason he's chayiv? If we have lavud, part of it comes out to be at rest, above 10 tefachim, because mechitzas l'seichen asoyis, the walls are made for the inside. Since the walls of the basket are made to contain what's in the basket, by such walls we do not say lavur, and therefore when it's 2.9 tefachim from the ground, we don't consider that the walls extend downwards. Rather, only when it actually rests on the ground is it considered at rest. And at that point, it's only 7.2 tefachim high. We have an object fully at rest in the Rishus HaRabim, and therefore the person is chayv. So to summarize, we had a teaching from Abaya. One case where the person is going to be chayv, and one when he's putter. He'll be chayv when he threw an object. He'll be putter when he threw a Rishus. And to that, Rava argued and said that in both cases he's putter, even when he threw an object. And the reason he's putter is because this object is 10 tefachim high, and it's inevitable that a little bit of it is not above 10 tefachim, since it's a basket made out of reeds. So a little bit must be above 10 tefachim. So both cases are putter, because there's a side thing that influences the din. And then we brought another teaching from Abaya and Rava together. Once again, one that's chayev, one that's putter. Chayev, when together with lavad, it still stays within the Rishus HaRabim. And putter, that when together with lavad, it ends up being in the Mokim Ptor. And to that, Rav Ashi said that they're both going to be chayev, not just when it's 7.1, but even when it's 7.2. And the reason is because this din of lavad that brings about the ptur, according to Abaya and Rava, Rav Ashi says, doesn't apply by a basket. So just to point this out, that Abaya gave a case of chayiv and putter, and Rava said they are both putter, because there's a thing that influences that they should both be putter, also the case that Abaya says is chayiv. And then Abaya and Rava brought two cases, one that's chayiv and one that's putter, and Rav Ashi said both are chayiv. Rava said both are putter to Abaya's first two cases. Here Rav Ashi says both are chayiv, and the reason is because what brings about the ptur in the case that Abaya and Rava say, Rav Ashi said, does not take effect over here, and therefore both cases will be chayev.